to ban.
I mean, not well.
Well, at least not in the Chinese.
I was going to say, they've definitely been used in one game. Probably in any or something. I don't know. Here we have it. VG Gaming Reborn versus EHOME. Two picks so far. Drow Ranger IO, VG Gaming Reborn. We're going to get that through, and that is... That has been what winning them games, you know. Game one. Remaining. Exactly what they ran, and it was very effective. EHOME, again, nothing too different from themselves. Disruptor, Timber, opening. Bands as well. This is kind of the same here as that we kind of joke around all series. VG Gaming Reborn going to be able to continue the strength though with the Drow strap, picking up Avenge as well. So it's going to, you know, obviously, the hero picks so far from the side. It's just interesting to see what EHOME do in response to the Drow lineup, which a lot of these Chinese teams, they just seem to be so good running. And it's got to be scary for EHOME. You know, they've got to realize we've let the Drow, and they've got to deal with
it. Yeah, I mean, the first game, it didn't really feel like EHOME. They were still trying to contest the draw, but all it took was really one bad engagement, and then VICI Gaming just ran all over them. So I'm hoping EHOME can avoid that situation for the second time around. They're going to have a chance to revise their draft a bit, maybe get a little bit more gap close, some control. Draw on the IO especially. Like, Disruptor is already a pretty good choice against IO because you can send him back after the reload kick. Static Storm is obviously very good.
Elder Titan's there.
Yeah, well, Elder Titan is still in the
pool. Elder Titan.
I mean, it's definitely... a good choice. I will never see a lineup and say Elder Titan is bad.
Pick the Doom first. This is interesting. I mean, it. Obviously, we saw what. Yeah, it was EHOME had last game, wasn't it?
Yep.
Who's playing? Old Lev.
Yeah.
Not Doom. Old Lev. So that was watching. Yeah. So the Doom again, and it was pretty good. You know, he had a great game. The Doom. He was farming the same, and it was so good against the Storm, which of course. Is definitely something that VR could be contemplating here. This is what they went for in the game. Catch out with the Storm coin. The question is going to be, will Doom be enough to put them off the picking? Because I think it's safe to say they're going to be looking to pick that Storm.
Yeah, it's the Omni hard counter. Like, you can't, I don't think, pick Omni into Doom. That's...
But can you pick the Storm into Doom?
Still. I think that's probably better than picking Omni into Doom. Especially if your plan is to pick Omni and Storm. Because then it just counters both heroes. So, Puck is more of an all-in choice.
Okay.
Obviously, it's going to do very well in the lane against the Timber.
Ooh,
oh no, it's going to be...
counter, DK.
Yeah, it's going to be Ice, Timber, and then most likely DK mid. So, safe lane Timber saw.
And I think I'll ask from EHOME. They're kind of the building up with a beefy lineup. You know what I mean? These are heroes that... The Drow strat... not going to be taking them down as quickly as it was in game one with each lineup there.
Yep.
So they're already tailing their lineup around this Drow lineup that VG Gamer Reborn going for. And finally, yeah, Brewmother ban. You never want to see a Brewmother sneak for the end. Even though it would have arguably been unlikely. Because if we saw, obviously, Doom and Timber still being the core, so...
Well, it could have been safe lane Timber, and then just, support slash roaming Doom.
It could have been. They just switched around. But most of the time, you know, these teams do like to run the Doom in a core position.
Yeah.
So, but I guess you just don't want any chance of kind of, you know, the surprise brood hitting your heart.
It destroys their lineup.
Yeah,
like, they have almost no wave clear whatsoever. It's only the Puck.
Yeah.
And we're assuming that the last pick is going to be some kind of offlane hero, and this Spur is already taken out, you know. We'll have to see what VICI Gaming want to go for. But I'm thinking that, you know, normally DK versus Puck heavily favors the Dragon Knight because you just simply tap damage to harass the hero out of lane, and eventually DK is just going to hit his farm and start hitting your tower. The other part about the matchup is Puck usually rotates, and when you rotate against Dragon Knight just kills the tier 1 because he pops his dragon and heats the tower, and then if there's no rebuttal, the tier 1 just dies, like, prior to, you know, 10-12 minutes into the game. So Sardar is going to be the choice here for EHOME as a ban. I like that ban because they needed something that is a secondary initiation on top of the Puck.
Yeah, I guess so. Anyway, it would have been a nice kind of frontline hero as well. But as you said, just jumping in, getting the slam down. And already looking at three heroes, so Doom's going to be building armor. Timbersaw and DK, they've got the passives with the armor build up. So it would have been a direct counter to that indeed. So EHOME now with their final pick. Even though there was a brood ban, I think you do just assume that this Doom is going to go lane. Or at least be a core position. So I'm more expecting to see a support hero here, but you know, things can change. EHOME can indeed, you know, adapt to what they feel is necessary to bring into the draft against VG Reborn.
Okay.
So it's more than likely, I mean, I guess this is going to be played in the sense that probably what? Old Eleven on the Axe and he'll go jungle, or Old Lanham on the Doom, he'll roam about bit, go into the offlane? Or do you think they'll switch you around? It's hard to...
I think Lynam will probably play Doom, that's my guess.
Yeah, let's go.
Alright, nasty curveballs being thrown in this specified series. But I actually like EHOME's lineup, because if the Axe gives him an early blink dagger, he can be so disruptive during the fight.
Ice
follows it up. You know, you have a disruptor as well who can drop the static storm and kinetic field on top of initiation.
Yeah.
And then you also have a Doom. So, you know, obviously there's multiple good Doom targets. You can throw it on the puck, you can throw it on the DA. A defensive save from the rotate of the swap is obviously going to be a thing, but you're still getting rid of a hero from the fight. And that's what matters the most. They showed in the last game that they can really abuse how good Doom is during this engagement, so I'm kind of expecting more of the same. On the flip side, you know, VG Gaming Reborn, they ran the Drill Strat in game one. They had a lot of success with it. They won the game. Under safe again in game number three.
EHOME. Cool towers this game.
Team with the most kills, I would actually say EHOME.
Most runes. We've got a TA. Turn on a teleport. Doesn't apply stun. Oh, that's a good one. 25 minutes? Oh, that is... that's a very particular one as well.
I would say, like, one.
I'd say... Yeah, I'm gonna go with two. But I think you're right. That's a tricky one. It's cool.
Because there's, like, does a Doom count as a stun? Because you still get your TP interrupted if you get Doomed. If you get Glimpse, does that count? Like, I don't know. It's
wording. Yeah. It's about... I like to be cryptic.
No.
Oh, yeah. But the 10 on a kill. Moving on top. Chicken. Old Lana was like, sorry, mate. I'm out. You dug yourself your own grave. First blood for VGR. Very nicely done as well. And, you know, any time with this kind of lineup, you're looking for action. You're with that position. Right. It adds up. You know, the extra bit of damage and can allow you to get the beat down. Yeah, nice play from VGR. Great way for them to start the game and to, you know, just kind of kick off the momentum that they're going to be looking to run with this draft that brought into the game.
The TA matchup with Aurora up against the Timber should be easy, I think, for Mikasa. It's a lineup that can snowball way harder than the previous iteration of their draw strat, because they actually have a hero who can kill Roshan. Like, yes. The TA with draw Aura just destroys Rosh. There's nothing that's going to be able to stop them. It's very low risk. They also have an IO. I'm assuming there's going to be some stacking going on, and, you know, we got a dual offlane here starting off from BGR. Yeah,
FY Yang, IO Puck.
I like it, though.
Yeah, the Timber Disruptor. And the mid laner was DK. He's going to be up against Mikasa's TA. And Old Man roaming around the side jungle. And we'll see him pop into the lane. And Old Levin getting himself ready for that start off in the jungle here on the Axe.
Well, it's going to be up to VGR to kind of dominate the laning phase here. You don't pick multiple range heroes. I mean, they actually don't have a single melee. It's 5 range plus Vengeance Drill.
Absolutely, just taking full advantage of that position aura.
Ice is gonna, like, completely suffer down here. Even as a Timber, he's gonna need, like, level 3 or 5. If he wants the 2 or 3 points into reactive armor, can really stay in the lane. But to the point, you know, Puck hits extremely hard. It's gonna be a little bit rough here for EHOME early on.
How's the mid lane gonna look?
I do think that Mikasa should still be fine. I don't know if Old Chicken necessarily dies or anything like that, because it's, you know, there's no disable. And I think that the likelihood of rotation coming in from BGR is pretty low. So I think that it's most likely that, you know, Mikasa and Old Chicken are just going to trade CS. But Sideblade Harass, pretty strong here from Mikasa. A lot of them.
Old Chicken's going to be careful. And a slight lead indeed for Mikasa on his TA. Now, quick reply. We'll close the game. Old Lang, been his best to be sneaky and grab those levels on the tree line. Let's be a little bit careful. Oh, and Ren's got the. Good stamp. Disruptor. Please. It's fine. Fenrir just trying to do his best to create some space for Ice on this spot. He's doing odd 11. So hit onto level. Yeah, he'll grab himself a rune as well. Rune that. That'll be well received. Gets him up to level 3. And he will continue his pretty fast jungling pattern. At least at this stage of the game, it's been all good for the Axe in the jungle. And you look at VGR's lineup, unlikely that they're going to be doing anything in terms of disrupting the Axe's jungle progression at this stage.
Yeah, I do think that maybe not addressing Ult 11 directly puts a little more pressure on VGR to just beat the lane that much harder. But truthfully, you know, Old Chicken isn't doing too bad. There's only one CS difference right now, or like one or two between Mikasa and him in the middle lane, which is fine. The Timber is still fine, a decent amount of CS, because he can tank almost an infinite amount of creeps under the tower. Like, reactive armor is just going to keep him at full health the whole time. So maybe EHOME are getting enough from this early game.
Yeah. Moving forward again with the AWP. Might look for a bit of a kill on to Famra. So we've got 1 point in the waning rift though, so not enough nuke damage. Still, they're just bullying this bottom lane. The Puck-IO combination, not something we see every day, but at the moment. Doing its best to slow down the farm of Ice.
Why? Super low here. Oh, goes down.
Damn.
Alrighty.
Ice and Famrit find themselves the down combo. And Jang, he's alone for the moment being. The first bit of action there for as they come back after, you know, losing out to the first blood with that early rotation from VGR before the bell was good at the start of the game.
I think that it's a bit troubling for VGR to lose a hero in a lane at this early stage. Like, the Puck lane with the IO is not really supposed to die. You just want to really heavily pressure, but I guess since Ice, you know, he's not had to support soak any EXP. We saw Old 11 sitting inside of the jungle just doing his own thing. Him getting the earlier points into reactive and being able to just shrug off the harass means that this dual aggressive lane coming out from VGR has suddenly become very ineffective. So, you know, hopefully they manage to regain their footing here. Old Lana taking some damage, gonna TP out.
Oh, it's close.
Yeah, he's there.
He's good. Not quite close enough there. Won't be able to finish him off. Famra making the pulls, controlling the lane here for Ice. He's taking a bit more harassment, but yeah, he's kind of now at that safe point, isn't he? Three levels in reactive, couple in the chain. It's gonna be very hard for these two to kill him.
There's pretty much no way they can even force him out of the lane anymore. It's just gonna be like, okay, you attack me, doesn't matter. I regen all the health in like 2 or 3 seconds, more or less.
And this mid lane, Old Chicken keeping up with Mikasa, slightly behind, but by no means shut down. He's still getting a bit from this lane, this DK, and a fair bit of that.
I mean, it's actually closer than I think it should be. Although, maybe I'm underestimating Breathe Fire a bit. The 35% damage reduction in this lane can be a huge difference. It more than offsets the aura from the Drow, so maybe that's what's kind of tipping the scales in his favor. But End is very close. Level 6, so as soon as that happens, Mark is out. He is going to be buffed significantly. That should be enough to make sure that Mikasa is hitting a tremendous amount of CS, because between Refraction and the Precision Aura, you have a huge amount of damage. Like, he almost hit for 200 5 minutes into the game. That's just insane.
Oh! What? I was looking at Tether over. He's trying to make it quiet for a bit, but it's like it doesn't matter. Oh, might be stuck out here. Yeah, FY! Oh no, a tether too short for the man. F is down. Well, Lemon, can you set up anything more actually here now? Moves in, gets the call off onto Mikasa.
Oh, they can
follow through.
But, he kind of needs a point into Battle Hunger if he wants to kill the TA.
Yeah, for the chasing. Yeah, actually, yeah. To get for those refraction charges. That's true. Oh, Chicken. Gets himself a kill. Mikasa still just trying to play around. This Axe picks up a DD and old Axe. Oh, he's actually got the Chop Chop! He needs another spin before he can get the Chop Chop. FY at the hills! Oh!
No spins! Man, that is really unlucky.
What an unlucky map. Meanwhile, Old Lanham. Now DDC, he has the Purple Ball of Doom. He'll give it.
Very well. There.
Now Ice as well. He's looking for more. Great TP rotation. Can they stop him? It doesn't look like they can. He's moving in. And he kind of back up for End. How deep does Ice want to go? He has three in the reactive. Nice silence, and that's enough to spook him. Salving up, they're looking to turn on Ice. And we've got quite enough control. Ice is going to be fine at the same time. Lower down, Mikasa. Things are moving on to Fenrir, but Dragon Tail. There we call as well, getting into position. Mikasa got a bit too aggressive. I'll bring him down.
I think they're just going to dive this.
They're ready to rock and roll. And they've got an Axe and a Timber ready to frontline. The Glimp back and rip the rail away from his team. They'll zip across, take him. Gone for more. They're not done. Old 11 and Ice. There's the Dream Call. He'll get him. Oh, goal! Ice. Still doing his best to find the kills, but it's not going to be enough. They play around it. And Axe's bravado will be punished.
And they are just going in right now. And Axe doing this much work in the early game without the use of a blink. Like, it's 7 minutes in! Old 11's just running at them. And the funny part is, Vici, they don't really have a counterplay because there's no swap and no relocate. Like, this Venge is level 2! DDC is level 2 at 8 minutes into the game.
Oh, dear.
Alright, things are looking pretty up here for EHOME in the early game.
Stop. He's gonna make it go on twice, twice. Has it got enough control?
Actually, yeah. Quite a bit of damage here. Oh, zips across.
Yeah, he's actually thinking about moving forward. Needs to be
he's
careful.
Gonna get a glimpse, maybe.
Now, let's see if they do it. They will indeed. Bringing him back. Jack Ram to follow through. And Yang. Okay, so the back of the left wide. Jumping in. Yeah, still playing around.
Oh, once
getting
no.
Ice, ice, ice. Kill, can he? See, spaceship dodge. Yang's. It's a player from the bar.
It's going in.
Chop, chop, chop. Oh, the creep. Stuck in the trees. Oh.
Both ways.
As well. Oh, dear.
Yang, what a player.
5k. 8.5k.
That was so good, actually. You know, if it creep wave, that would have been completely great. Yeah, very nicely done there from the side of each air. So I can
miss. Not good, I think. At least. The kills there. So, yeah. Just took a tier 1 on himself. 6-6 on the board. As we see, now we're 3-9. But it's not a big difference. A very, very close state of the game. But VGR starting to get a little bit of that momentum that they find with the drow line. And certainly a bit of a similar flow to what they were able to get in game one with the drow lineup to secure themselves a win against EHOME.
Well, it wasn't like the greatest start for VGR. To be fair, it was. And then, they get one good Roshan fight, and all of a sudden it's like, oh, we just win the game. So we'll see if they have a similar complexion in this third match in the best of five series here. But I'm feeling like EHOME have more to say in this game. You know, they have Blink Dagger timing that's going to be coming up on Old 11. He's only about 800 away. He's been very active in early game, involved in half the team's kills. Most of the time, you don't see a lot of rotation until the Blink Dagger is actually available. But Old 11 not wanting to sit on laurels for too long. And I really like his filter item as well. He went for the casual buckler. He ate an ogre as well, so he's got the ice armor. It's going to help a ton against the lineup of VGR, who is, once again, almost entirely comprised of physical DPS.
I'll see what goes on here in the mid lane. Eho.
Relocate. Bottom.
Hello. Size. They've caught him out. They've brought him down. VGR. As you said, with the relocates that are necessary to find these kills onto Hero there. Why is this? In a lot of trouble, but it's a good glimpse, though. It's going to catch Kassa back out post-re-relocate. There's really any way to play around this. He's going to go for a Fenrir kill, but Old 11 says no. Don't hit Fenrir. Hit me. Oh, Makasa tries for it with a final meld hit. Is he going to make it? And they will find that the kill in return after losing ice on that bottom lane, EHOME.
A little bit of a missed dunk there from Old 11, but in the end, they still get the kill, so that's really all that matters. And with that, Blink is coming out extremely soon. As of right now. I think this is going to be the point in the game where VGR have to really be playing well. Like, yep. They have to outmaneuver, they really need DDC to get six. They've been prioritizing him ever since, we talked about him only being two. So at that point, he managed to recover to level 5.5. Once he gets six, they're going to have that defensive. They're going to have the relocate on FY, and then they can actually for counterplays. Because before that point, if that Blink Dagger somehow manages to come out before. Hard. Because then you have to worry about Blink initiation, Static Storm, and whatnot, or a Doom, perhaps, and then you more or less just lose the fight. But I'm looking at this right now. The Axe. Every tool that you need is up for both teams. Like, they have all their core items.
They really do. Both teams are. It's just going to be a question of who looks to take first. A few hours away from finishing, get that done before they go for a full out push, full out fight next time round. And this rune in the bottle is used as well.
Now the Hawk has his as well, so.
Yeah, double blink now done.
I think,
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
This is about to go down. actually buying us. Oh, never mind. FYR. Bias told me the blinks came out though. One of those burn time for VGR and EHOME alike.
That's either way.
Shoot,
I'm coming in, smoke on, smoke. Yeah, where's the only bit? Oh no! Get it off! Immediate reaction emphasize DDC finds us! Gorilla, get it out! VGR by the puck still falls! Two drop down onto me home, focusing towards the TA. There's a buyback from the axe, he's gonna try and get himself back into the fight. Ice turning full well. Tipping across, they found the second kill. FY and the boys need to get themselves out of there. Tever the cross, he will keep himself alive. Will they be able to catch anything else out here? Doesn't look like he can close that gap. But they find themselves two kills. And as we saw, they just puck a little bit slow to react as the smoke dispelled. And EHOME absolutely, you know, lightning reactions with the static storm and the berserker's call blinking to make sure nothing happens. They did use the axe buyback. Overall, coming out with a favorable trade.
The buyback was so fast. Like, old 11 almost bought back immediately when he died. I know that Roshan is always going to be something that Beach looking to, and maybe that's why he felt like he had to buy back. Just to go Beach lose Roche for sure.
Wolf in, Dream Call. It's going to be on the left side. Dive, Sarnas on top chicken, so he can't really help out. Ice Eyes. But the Timber Chest, snap back on the call, is going to take him. And Ice, you know, for a Timber game, she has died a few times here, 14 minutes in, and they're going to use that open. They're going to head straight into the Roche champ here. And it's all there before. EHOME is desperate to try and stop this from happening. Question is, can they do it without a Timber Saw in the game for 50 seconds? And looking at the speed of VGR taking it, I think the answer is no, Andy.
Yeah, this is VG's strongest position. So that very toxic is his hand on the Aegis there. Templar Assassin with a 2 loss. EHOME half the back. Can no longer fight this.
Oh, leveling it away. Gotta be careful, they're gonna be scared. Mikasa leading the way, and the Roshan charges will be taken out by the Valhunga. Static Storm gonna catch the man. Mikasa the man with the Aegis though. Angst by DDC, now moving. But gonna take TA at least will. Aegis now pop. May actually find themselves getting out of this one. Old Lanham. And Ice trying to chase forward for the waning wrist silence. Ice in trouble. Mikasa jumps across. The right clips fly in. Take down the Timber Saw. Again, home. They're losing the fight pretty heavily here. Can they get themselves anything more? VGR magic missile onto Fenrir, he'll glimpse back the vent, but that doesn't matter. Castle's going to be the one to finish off the job. Triple kill on the TA. And EHOME, they lose a fight, they lose, and then they go on to lose another fight. This is now the momentum that VGR were hoping for. And EHOME, they're getting to a point where they've got them to stop it, because VGR are starting to run this game.
I mean, Radiation is just so crazy now, with the multiple blinks, the relocates, the swaps, they're just... No way EHOME can really avoid the engagement if you're running at them. They just had to be able to get out faster. Like, they even spot Old 11 they want to go on this. I mean, clearly, Old 11 is a bit too far away at the moment. But they're completely thwarting EHOME's item progression. They're not doing anything out of that. VGR are the ones who are pressuring. They throw Shan, they go... Let's go war.
Here comes McDrana, focus on taking the backup, is there for EHOME, but is he going to be enough? Oh, cheer, no, take down. I don't know anything to... They are bringing out Ace, as you said, jumping and looking for every opportunity to find kills, and EHOME, they're just getting caught off guard each and every time. EHOME team's there to potentially back them up.
Not for each year. They just have a very good understanding of other team options. You know, we talked about in the first match, and the Chinese region to love this zone. It's going right now and how powerful it can actually be. Like right now, End is working his way to TK. He's almost got it, and the Dragon Lance. Oh, and it's 16 minutes into the game, and the guy has this much farm.
All relocate to Rune. Old Mana. And they are trying for this switch just to poke and an IO. I say that. There comes the Catcher for the finishing blow.
Even with like the casual buckler and the ice armor, he still just cannot stand to the damage. I don't really know what they're supposed to do at this point. They're relying so heavily on like a big axe call from Old 11. Like, he finishes the blade mail, for example, gets the call. But even if that happens, you still have relocate, you still have swap. Like, there are ways that VG surrounds us, and they just... They're going for all the towers now.
11, oh, Dream Call dropped down. 11, he's gone, didn't even get the chance to cast Berserk.
Yep.
VG Reborn. They are stepping it up to the max here in this game against EHOME. And I think so far, series. Stop dropping this game.
Yep.
They're gonna be scared. The China region really is. They're just pulling out the big spot. It's a game for. Nice swap from DC keeping Yang up. FY's with the heels on the IO and they just can't find you. In fact, Yang takes them down. They're jumping for more. Lanham's trying to find something. They just fight him out. FY keep it alive. They'll pop him out with the gun. They're going to try to take it down. Trying to move in, but the damage rushing for the IO is too much. He can't do it. VG Reborn. This is.
It's a murder now. They're like, it
just doesn't stop.
The golden experience, like, the gold is in the excess of 12,000 right now at 18 minutes, and the experience is making its way towards 10k. This is just unmitigated disaster for EHOME. They had a couple of nice early engagements, and, you know, I have to give credit to Ent. He had this really clutch gust in the enemy woods where he hit 3-ply where the tier 1 in the bottom lane used to be, and it stopped Lannan from being able to get off his doom. I'd say that gust kind of put them in this position where they had already taken Roshan. We saw how effective they can snowball their momentum off the Roshan the first game, and they just never take their foot off the gas.
Let's just look at the individual net worth. You got an IO, FY, has a mech done.
He's
only...
he's got more net worth than the Timbersaw safe lane. Like, what?
FY.
They have to ban Drow, right? Like, they can't let the 0-3 again.
It really seems like Drow is just insta-winning the Chinese region. The team is just so good with using it. And now Drow, 90-minute PKB Yasha Dragonlance. The Desolator, Ampling, Stomach Cancer, they're just going to go in for the finishing blow. Need to win this fight, otherwise they might fuck up out.
Yeah, this is a little bit much. They're gonna go to the high ground.
We go to the setup immediately. Good fight.
Oh my god.
No. Samurai's out. Owl Chicken start up as well. He doesn't have to do anything. Himself, and he's gone. Two out. Just like that. As quick as paint.
Oh Jesus. So you're playing the Chinese qualifiers, and you ban Drow out because you can counter it. PGR picture and then you lose.
Old 11. And here comes Mikasa, open wide.
I wouldn't even plan with that. It's just that these lineups that Vici run with the hero make it so that if you get like one Roche and you have one good team fight, you just win the game. Like,
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
I really like the touch of the TA as well. Like, we noted that Storm is still in the pool, and I think that he has been a way worse pick. Like, after seeing what the TA played out, just allowing them to get... And they're diving.
Yeah, here we go. Dream Colossus to Mikasa kills one now. He's gonna kill the second. Femris out. Static Storm will be there, but the BKB doesn't care. Silence on twice outside, forcing him back. Now, if it looks toward Old Chicken, they'll be able to keep themselves alive. For the rest of the team, it's a different story. Axe is now back for PGR. They down the tower, he's got the racks, oh, and they go ice. He's got to be careful at the same time. GK okay. Will jump in, off 11, they'll finally kill the Drow, but it doesn't matter. Meld hit from Mikasa, he may move in for even more. He's contemplating it. They'll look for the objectives though, potentially. Now they're actually going to back out. Okay, play it safe. They did lose the Drow. There's a fair bit of damage output, obviously taken away from the side with the Drow gone. But still, I mean, not by no means a bad fight for the side. That's not accounting the other kills there. Good old fight recap.
I mean, getting Ed killed there was probably the best thing that could have happened. Because he's the one who pretty much enables the push. Even if it's like TA and everyone else on the side of Ichi, they lose a huge chunk of damage as soon as that Drow dies, just because of marksmanship and the precision or competition. So, slowing the push enough to force Ichi to think twice about sticking around, and they'll have to wait for him to respawn. Roshan going to see the timer in about a little less than a minute. And I think that EHOME, if they give away this Aegis, it's going to be a slow siege. Well, truthfully, it won't be that slow of a siege, just because of how much damage they do. But, I don't know, man, like, just look at the net worths. It's insane. Like, the DK has 7,500. The Wisp has 7,200. Like, come on.
Wow, suck. Just dumb.
FY has a mech, arcanes, earn, full on bottle. 22 minutes in, and this guy was in a little offlane, as I.
Yeah, here we go. Oh, time to party again. Dream call onto two. Gunners follow through as well, and here we have the damage pumping. Chicken will get a stun onto Mikasa. It's only going to delay the inevitable. The swap backslide down. My Sasa's got his Bloodstone.
I mean, the DK has Black back, but I'm not entirely sure how much that's going to matter. I think he's also going Chainmail. He decided to pick up a Chainmail, or maybe he just wants to go AC. I'm not even sure if there's one item that's going to really matter that much.
There's a buyback hit.
Oh, there's a Blade Mail on the axe.
They may need to have a Shroud. Okay, here we have it. Magic Missile.
Oh, the relocate. Perfect.
Save. Yang does get chopped down. They've lost the puck. VGR. Oh, I don't want to go rebound. Yeah, buyback on the puck. Trying to get him into the fight here. He's on his way down the mid lane. They really want to just... I mean, that buyback, I guess they want to just finish it. Or at least get Roche nearly back up.
Yeah, it's a short respawn. Really good thing for VG.
Back up in 10. So, if they can kill some of these heroes, I mean, we'll see who these buy. It's just the DK, yeah, it's just the DK. The DK, Garen's, you know, obviously already in a very good position, VGR, but you're in an even more disgustingly far position. If you can kill that.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I guess the question is, you know, what's the perfect engagement for EHOME? That hits a multiple call, I guess? But that's going to be a really tall order.
Yeah, it's cool into static stone, really.
But we saw how fast FY reacted to the last fight.
Yeah, like, FY's position has been absolutely on point.
But that's one of the big issues, right? Like, yeah. EHOME's lineup, they only have one real form of initiation. I suppose the Dragon Knight had a blink too, but you kind of need to, like, jump on the Wisp and the damage dealer at the same time. So either Mikasa or, I suppose, End are the two best targets outside of that. But I think the Axe has to go on the drill because you need the Blade Mail to be able to deal damage. Even with the BKB activated, obviously Blade Mail serves quite a decent amount. And with Roshan being such a short respawn, VG are going to get it for free. There's no way that EHOME are going to get here in time. They're just trying to find some kind of farm out on the map where they know that most likely the Dire is doing something like this. But they just can't stop it. It's too difficult.
VGR. Aegis Tomikasa. Manta Star now complete. It's from strength to strength. It's level 60 as well. None of that really matters too much at this point. And the line is drawn. Straight down the middle. At least that was the call from Old Lemon. He says this is what they're going to do. Indeed, he's bang on.
Can I just say how impressed I've been with Mikasa throughout this qualifier? Like,
he's had a few bad games.
Yeah, but overall,
this you can't take anything away from this guy.
He usually has bad games when any player I feel like would have bad games.
I'm gonna be able to take him down once, but immediately Yang jumping in. Dream Coil onto both Old Lanham and Ice, we're gonna lose the 2. Call onto 3, they need to start finding kills. And swapped out, they're just gonna allow him to turn around, take down the Drow. Drow will get double kill. And looking for Roll Chicken, BKB silence up, chomping through Fenrir one more touch, but no, keeps himself alive. VGR maybe struggling here with this fight, and Berserker's call is there, the burst down. Okay, the defense is looking good. Well, I say that DK did get found out at the back. So by all means, not the end of the road there for VGR, but they are playing heroes. Blink it from Yak. Ooh, okay, that's big. All right.
That was a very solid defense, but honestly, that was the first time we've seen Vici actually get out of position. That was the 3-man call. Yeah. There's no reason why the Drow... Yeah, the Drow should never be standing next to the Io, like, ever. The whole purpose of having the Io in the vent is to make sure you have heroes sitting in the backline who can go for a defensive relocate whenever, you know, they decide to go aggressive. But that positioning allowed EHOME to defend. If they just go for the standard, have the throw on the TA hitting on the towers on the, or not the towers, the Raxes on the high ground, you can split it, put one on the range, one in the melee, and then have one save for each of them, then EHOME engaging becomes significantly harder. But because they all walk up into this kind of choke point, and maybe it would fit on Mikasa, like going to high ground really fast and trying to deal a little bit of damage, that they got clumped up and get punished hard for it.
Does Mikasa just farm up a BKB, or what's the call really next for TA?
BKB is not... It's not bad, I suppose. Stop damage. You can still get duped, but Blade Mail is going to be an issue, I think, no matter what.
That's true.
So yeah, maybe BKB. I like it. If your idea is to end the game...
Yeah, it's a great game anyway.
Yeah, then I think BKB would be solid.
Now VGR, not looking
too keen on going straight again for another play. They'll be happy just working out some of these next few options. Yang starting to build up the gold again. So the quest now finished by the men. See what the next call is going to be. They're just going to head to top, start to push that lane out. This is getting a little bit too close for comfort. Mikasa sitting at 3.5k, yet to spend it. So maybe indeed just looking for the 3.975 so he can pick up a straight out BKB. Dagon is actually going to be the pickup for Yang as he proceeds with his build.
And I suppose at this point, VGR might be feeling a little bit more cautious about just running into EHOME, because it doesn't take more than like one or two more fights like that to where EHOME could potentially bring themselves back into the game, because you're giving away a lot of net worth whenever you fail a push like that and you're losing like multiple heroes, especially against something like Doom. So I'm feeling right now that VGR, it could be a little bit before they decide to push again. They do have the 10 on the TA and NSPB is still 8 seconds, so perhaps I feel like this is enough, but I feel like the safest thing to do is wait for another Rosh.
Okay.
But I suppose they want to try to go. I mean, their lineup is technically stronger at this point in the game, so taking a fight isn't out of the question. It's just, it might be this risk.
Alright, jump this lineup. That's going to be the worst out of the fight out of Jackal. Now, all chicken.
Yep.
Look for the setup. I mean, he's just the back line. Because he jumps and he's being tuned up though. The BKB was out in time, but he's got to be careful. Moving in as well with End on the trigger. Pummeling into them, but the position. Got to be careful as DDC drops low. Still forcing them forward and okay. The puck jumping in. Yang zaps down one. Then one of them does another old chicken. Gets the stun off onto Yang. They'll take down the puck here. Fly back from Doom. Keeping Mikasa alive though. It's still looking good. Magic Missiles in control. And then Mikasa comes in for the finishing touches. Now on Tice. He'll kill himself. And VGR. They've still found the fight that they've wanted. Unless how much pressure they can pump. No back double on the threes. Now currently dead on EHOME. Old Lano's there, but he himself is in the buyback to this hole, or at least what he can try to attempt it. And a full gauge by some time,
but this might be that's like DK and Axe are just dead for too long. Their initiators are both dead, and there's no disruptor ultimate and no doom.
I'm not Lanham, yeah, he's just gonna be so careful.
He's come a little bit too close for comfort. Oh, Lanham's gone, that's the dieback.
That's gotta be this game, right?
Yeah, GG's cool by that. It was all too much for EHOME and VGR with quite a performance indeed.
Very impressive stuff. I mean,
without
just bad troll. He's just bad. It's not worth what through the GR. I would even be okay with EHOME themselves.
Yeah,
I just think that the hero, the way that the Chinese just run it, it's just constant aggression. VGR open up with the eye on the draw. Two games, they get two victories. They're not fixing it, Brook. EHOME have to adapt. They can't just continually let this through because it seems like they play the lineup extremely well. It's not even just about the hero combination. It seems to be like the comfortability with it. And VGR just have that. So if you're in the situation, you're playing to guarantee your spot at regional qualifier. You don't have to prove that you can beat Drow. You just need to, it's like the ethic.